Hello children, this is Seema Singh again with the new video. Today we are going to do grammar and we are going to do chapter number 9. And the chapter number 9 is adjectives and page number 46. Children, can anybody tell me what is adjectives? You must have learnt it in second standard. Little bit. Okay, chalo, let me tell you what is adjective. Adjectives are the word that describes noun or that tells us something about the noun. It describes the name of a person, place, thing and animal. It tells us what kind of people they are, what kind of animal it is, whether it's fat, thin, tall, short. It tells about the place, whether the place is big, small, clean, dirty. It tells about the things, what is the shape, what is the color of the things. Okay, so adjectives are the word which describes people, which describes animal, places, things. It also tells us about the color, shape and sizes. So in simple words, you can say the words that describes people, animal, places, things are called adjectives. Okay, so let's see some example. Smart boy. What kind of boy he is? He's a smart boy. So here smart is describing the boy. Garden, big garden. Here garden is name of place. What kind of garden it is? Big. Yes. Flower. Red flower. What kind of flower it is? Red. Sweet bird. What kind of bird it is? Sweet. Round table. What kind of table it is? Round. Pretty dress. What kind of dress it is? Pretty dress. Okay. So if you say adjectives are the words that describes shape. Shape can be square, it can be round, it can be triangle, it can be rectangle. So any shape it can describe. Color. Color can be red, green, pink, brown, black, white. It can be anything. Size. It tells us about whether the thing is big, small, long, short or etc. It tells us about the number. It can be 1, 2, 5, 10, 15, 20. It may be 100 also. It tells about the thing which feel, whether it is rough, it is soft, it is hard. Okay, it tells us about the thing. It tells us about the like or the looks of the thing, like beautiful, pretty, old, young, ugly. So all such special qualities it describes. It tells us about the sound. It tells us whether it is loudy, whether the sound is loud, it is slow. It tells us about that. Okay, and it also tells us, as I told you, it also tells us about the shape. So adjectives are the words which describe shape, which describes color, size, number, feels or the quality, looks or sound. Okay, so normally adjectives are placed before the noun, but in some cases it is also placed after the noun. I am happy for you. Yeah, what kind of feeling he is having? Happy feeling. And it can come in the last of that adjective, can come in the last also. I don't look very happy, or you don't look very happy. So your happy is come at the last. And in the first sentence which I told you, you can see happy in between, that is before the noun. So okay children, there are 3 degree of comparison. Comparison means adjectives can be compared in 3 ways. The 3 ways of comparison are positive, comparative and superlative. But here we are going to do comparative degree. Comparative degree is the degree when we compare two things, okay, of the same kind. Like two boys are compared. Who is smarter? Whether Rahul is smart or Ravi is smart. But when we are comparing, we are going to add ER to word. Rahul is smarter than Ravi. Okay, here we are adding ER. And always when you add ER, the word noun, the word then comes after the noun. Okay, let's see with example. Okay, an ant is smaller than a mouse. Here I'm making comparison between ant and mouse. Here when I'm making comparison, here small is going to change to smaller. Here we are going to add er to the noun, and that er will be followed, that adjective will be followed by then. Here an ant is smaller than a noun. Okay. Ankit is taller than Rahul, or Rahul is smarter than Ankit. Okay, it can be anything, but when we are using this er, it will be followed by then. Small, some more examples: small, smaller; rich, richer; black, blacker; bold, bolder; clean, cleaner. Okay, so we are going to do this comparative degree, but there are two more, that is positive degree. When no comparison is made, the adjective is put like that only without adding anything to it. But and er is added when we make comparison between two, and that is known as comparative degree. When comparison is made between many or between the whole thing of the same kind, it is known as superlative. Okay, so when we compare between two, er is added to the noun, right? And when we compare with whole of the same kind, est is added to the noun, right? But we are going to do only the er one, okay? Not the est one. So children, this is all for today. See you tomorrow with the same chapter, and we are going to do the textual exercise from the textbook. Okay, so this is all for today. See you tomorrow with another video. Till then, goodbye.